here to make a statement in terms of our unequivocal, non-negotiable position that the Pickaninny art, the thoroughly racist Pickaninny art, white supremacist-based Pickaninny art on the public carousel at the public beach, which both of which are maintained with our tax dollars, must come down immediately. And we're not playing any waiting game until next season and so forth. Our demand is that it must come down now. And then we can have a discussion, a community discussion, about what to do with it once it's taken down. In fact, we can make that part of the teachable moment that everybody keeps talking about, right? We know that many people in our community, including black people and other people of color, do not really understand the history behind this. They don't understand what it's all about. We've even seen, it breaks your heart that we've seen black people stand before the cameras of mass media and make statements about they're not offended, they don't know why we're making the noise and so forth. Well, that's precisely what part of what we want to do is educate people so that they will know, so that they understand this is not about just some isolated piece of art, but this is about a historical era in this nation in which black people were systematically portrayed as buffoons and caricatures and idiots by white, racist white actors in the entertainment industry who went around the nation doing this for well over 100 years. I think some people, certainly people my age, will relate to Buckwheat as part of the Little Rascals, Andy and Amos, and even those shows were part of the same history, and those shows went into the 1960s. They were still on television. This is big in terms of capitalism and commercialism. The so-called captains of industry during the 1800s got in on this. They began to put those caricatures on commercial products, on rice boxes, flour bags, pancake packaging, and so forth, to help sell their products, which racist white people love. You know, and we still got remnants of that today. We still got Aunt Jemima on a pancake box. We still got Uncle Ben on a rice box. They've dressed them up now, and they supposedly look dignified. But when we put that in historical perspective, that also should be unacceptable. And so we're saying that, you know, it must come down. Hopefully we can continue an education campaign around this and really begin to connect it to other issues, because this is not, we know racism is not just about picking any art or caricature. It's about a whole lot of other things. It's about jobs. It's about justice. It's about housing. It's about health care and so forth. And the fact that people of color, poor people, are disproportionately denied those things that I was just listening. Racism is a factor in all of that. And so we hopefully we can really get people to see the larger issues is what we hope to move toward. And so the Take It Down campaign is kind of a springboard in terms of our larger issues and problems in this community, many of which are connected to racism.
We're here demonstrating against the carousel, which has a picture that the county is trying to fit as art and something of historical value, when it has not. Actually, when you really look at the picture, it's a picture of child endangerment. You've got a big rooster confronting a very little black girl against the wall. She's cowering in fear. And this art represents a cock rooster, is a rooster that they use for cockfighting. And in the days of slavery, they used these roosters to amuse themselves by sicking the rooster on the kids and keep disciplining them and training the rooster to fight better. And in this picture up here, it represents that rooster confronting a little black girl, cowering in fear. The rooster's neck feathers, or hackles as they're called, is raised. It's ready to strike. What's about to happen to the little girl is inevitable. She's either going to be she's in danger to either be hurt or killed by this rooster. And that's the thing that everybody is overlooking. on this drawing that's up there. It has no historical value. It has no art value. But it does have one value. It shows how black folks were treated back then. And this is one of the things that my concerns, this is what I've spoken on.
Hello, my name is Monica Nan, and I'm co-chair of the Green Party in Monroe County. I live in Rochester, and we're here today to show support for the effort to take down the racist plaque at the carousel. And for the Green Party, we operate under 10 values that we use to guide what we do and speak to our concerns politically and in humanity. One of those values is social justice, action. And for us, there's no question that the depiction on the carousel is racist, degrading, and should not be there. It's understandable why people want to talk about it some, but in reality, it can't be there because of the terrible implications, historical and current, that it carries. So when you talk about social justice, that's often what happens, is we talk about it. What we want to do in these situations is have action. So that's why we're joining with others here today who are advocating action. The action is to take down the racist depiction at the carousel, and we hope that people will continue to join us in supporting that, because it is offensive to everyone in the community.
Now, our understanding is that the city owns the Dentzel Carousel, but it has been leased to the county for 100 years, and the county is responsible for maintaining it and securing it and so forth. And according to what the Preservation Board chairperson and an attorney for the city told us when we attended the Preservation Board meeting a couple of weeks ago, if anything is going to be changed on the carousel, the process is the county has to submit an application to the city's Preservation Board, and then the Preservation Board will make a decision as to whether or not they will act on the application. So our understanding is the process must begin with the county. And so that's why we're saying to the Brooks administration, to the person who's over Parks and Recreation, Larry, whatever his name is, that they need to start the process. However, there is the possibility that even some of that is misinformation, that the city can actually move on this without that application, since they own it, the city owns it. And so we don't know who's supposed to do what, but we just know that they need to be responsible and accountable and take it down. And then we can continue the discussion after that.
What happened today is we had a small rally, and I think the rally got our point across to Maggie Brooks that she needs to make a decision to take this painting down. But at the same time, the mayor is not going to get away scot-free on this one, because she's complicit with this too. And so both of them worked and get together, let them negotiate, and take this evil art down. That's what we're saying. Even though we had smaller numbers because it's a work day, we need to take it to the seat of power instead of being out there at the carousel. Take it to the seat of power, stand in front of 39 West Main Street, and demand that this thing come down. Because I sent her a letter, Ted, about 2 weeks ago. She has never responded. I followed up with 3 phone calls. She has never responded. So, as far as I'm concerned, she's being obstinate, and she does not want to do what we are asking her to do. And we're being nice about it right now.
What happens when it gets taken down?
Well, that needs to be an ongoing discussion.
Okay.
So we're not advocating that it be destroyed. Okay. I think somebody did make that statement, but that's not us. We're not advocating that. We're saying, let the community decide. Let's have a discussion about what to do with it. You know, I got my thoughts. My thoughts are it should be given to the Frederick Douglass Resource Center. Mm-hmm. I can't think of a better place. And in that spot, we know proper education will take place around it. Because that's another thing. We don't need to just hang it in a museum somewhere. Might as well leave it hanging on the carousel. And we need people who are going to do the education. They have to know the history themselves. And so it is something that we need to think carefully about. But the Frederick Douglass Resource Center, perhaps the, I think it's called Rare Books and Articles or something section of U of R in the basement in the corner in the dark somewhere. You know, I don't know. Somebody has said, suggested the Child Museum of Play at Strong. I'm not so sure.
I'm
not so sure that would be a good location.
Right.
But that needs to be a discussion, a community discussion, which is, as I said, is a way to continue the education around this so that we will know the history.
Which reaches out to those bigger issues we're talking about.
Absolutely. Yeah. Absolutely.
And, like, somebody took direct action against the panel and actually defaced it or destroyed it.
Well, we don't want to be associated with that. We haven't advocated that. We're not advocating it and so forth. But, I will make the observation that many of our youth are not as tolerant as some of us who are a little more seasoned, right, a little more age. But we're not urging anybody to do that, you know, but we do have to acknowledge the possibility.
Right, it exists.
Yeah.
Anything else you want to say about it?
No, just that hopefully people will join in with us in terms of not only bringing that down, but really beginning to address the larger issues in our community that we got in this community right now, no less than 7 or 8 groups, all of whom are talking about dealing with racism and so forth. There's the free, facing race, embracing equity. There's the YWCA stand against racism. There's Metro Justice, Racial Justice Committee. Yeah, there's a whole list of this so-called Unite Rochester coming out of the Democrat and Chronicle, right? All of these groups, all of whom are saying they want to address structural racism. And so here's a time to show, right, to put your action where the words are and so forth, because we're not going to talk racism away. We're going to have to do something.
Right.
And what has become, it has always been crystal clear for many of us, but I believe it's becoming clear for more people, is that you can't do this without confrontation. There are people who have power. You know, this is about power. People who have a power to change laws, rules, regulations, policies, procedures by which the structural racism is maintained. We're going to have to step to some of those people. This is not some, you know, love fest and so forth. It's about power.
Lastly, what's next?
Well, we want to go back, you know, and we're not going to take a long time, so we want the community to keep their eyes and ears open. But I don't want to say on the spot what the next move is without us having a discussion. You know.
But there's going to be an next move.
Oh, no, absolutely. This is not one that's going to get dropped.
Right.
No doubt about it.
All right, cool.
All right. Thanks.